what's good? It's LJ Ruffin.
Chris the God.
Alright, and this is Freaks for Sneaks. So today we got another video. We have just our overall opinion on the KD7s, due to the fact that KD8 is about to come out. We just want to give our personal opinion on the KD7s, and if that's kind of going to persuade us to go with the 8s or just stay with what we have. So let me go first. So one of the colorways I got the easy, bad apple. I got the bad apples or good apple, whatever you want to call them. They kind of remind me of the Yeezys, you know? So, like, I really had to cop these when I got them. I mean, when I saw them, of course. And, they're not beaters, but, like, with this type of material, like, on your shoe, like, it definitely stains sometimes. I'll show you a good look up in that if you haven't seen it already. And then also, I did get the socks that did come with it, the bad apple socks. So, great cop. Your turn.
You know, you seen them before. I got the KD7s. I think they call it the Thunderbolts. To me, I like the shoe. It's just that if I wear them for a long, it's just me. If I wear them for a long time, then you know, it kind of, the toe box kind of hurts. So you know, I think it's a good performer and everything, but you know. That's just my opinion.
Alright. Next up, eggnogs. You know, I got these during Christmas time. Let me tell you the real reason why I got these shoes, right? I got these because Chris wanted these crap, and I knew if I got it, I'll piss him off. I got these shoes, yeah, the eggnog. I like that insole right there. 35 ounces. That's real tough. They also put that on the,
So
that's a good look. Got that eggnog material. You're gonna see the close up in a second. We'll talk about it in a second. So yeah, that's the KD7s.
Dead stock, you guys.
Oh yeah, dead stock. I haven't worn these
yet. Size 10.
If you guys want these, leave us something in the description box. Reasonable prices. I kind of want a little bit more than what I paid for them. You know, due to the fact that I paid like one. The retail on them is,
I think, 170, right?
Got the tags off, so
probably 170.
You see how much? Yeah.
It was like, no, because like that was 150, so that'd be,
yeah, 170. These are 170. So Chris, let's give our overall opinion. So first off, I'm gonna start with performance wise. How do you feel about a KD7s?
I want to say the main thing I like about it is the traction. The traction is A1. Really, it's just traction. Yes, to me, it's just the traction. Anything else is boo boo to me. Cause since I'm kind of like a big person, like a center wise, like these are not the shoes for me. My foot isn't really secure when I wear these. They kind of like slip and slide in these. So that's really just my opinion.
Just like you do to Olivia. Continue.
He likes Olivia.
All right, stop. Don't move the camera. All right, so that's your opinion on performance aspect. All right, so my opinion on performance aspect, traction wise, it's aight. It ain't the greatest, but it's okay. They're comfortable. Like, it's just a real weird shoe to like really compare with for me, because personally, I like the sevens, but out of the 2015 like basketball series, the 12s were the best to me. The LeBron sells. Those are just comfortable,
they're fierce,
last long, like, yo. But the sevens, hey, I didn't really play that many games in these. Like, most of my regular season for my league, I normally went to KD5 Elite. If you didn't know by now, my favorite shoe is the KD5 Elite. I know you're like, why is this KD5 Elite? Like, it's just a great lightweight shoe. I just feel like when I'm in that, like, I'd be like, whop. I'm a fast dude. You may haven't seen me yet, but like, yeah, I'm pretty fast, dude. So the KD5, like, that's just I feel like there's nothing on my feet. Like I'm just going. So on performance aspect, I would probably give them maybe a 7.5 out of 10. But since the KD said, let's give him a 7. There you go, bars.
Why you lower it down?
Lower what down?
You said a 7.5 out of 10. You said it's something to KD 7, a 7 out of 10. I was like, why'd you lower it down?
Alright, next up, casual. You think it's a good casual shoe?
No, not at all. These are not a casual. To me, they're not a casual shoe. Really, the only thing you can wear is just that outfit. You know, with the socks, shorts, shirt. That's the only outfit you could wear. But anything else, no, you can't. No.
All right, let me get my opinion. Personally, I think these are definitely a casual shoe. Just in my opinion, this is my thing with Chris. Chris has shoes. He doesn't have as many shoes as me. So, like, the colorway he has.
Bro, okay. All right. Nah, man. All right. Stop, man. We're not bringing this in, all right?
All right. Let me just finish. So, the colorway he has is not that. It doesn't really work with that many things. So, like, that's why I think he really said that. But, me personally. Chill out. Don't hit this camera. But, me personally. All right. I guess I'm doing the rest of the video by myself. So me personally, I definitely think it's a casual shoe. The strap, it looks very sexy. The eggnog, the khaki. Ooh, that's sexy. Sexy! Ew. I do like how I did you the yeah. And since Chris was not here, I'm just gonna do my final overall on the shoe. Great performer. Casual shoe. It looks good. I really like how they brought the strap back. I stay fresh with the snapback. Jay Jones, get off me. Thank you very much. But anyways, like, it's just a great shoe overall. I personally want the 8s, but that price change, I guess Chris is going to come back. That price change is really just kind of killing me right now. Because in the basketball, Nike basketball series, the fact that they always made the Kevin Durant signature shoe always the least amount in price, that really why I really like the KDs. So now that the fact that they're making it kind of a higher price is really kind of like, eh. So maybe now the cheap shoe will now be the Kyrie ones. Maybe that's why they bumped it up, so they could make people pay a little bit more for the Kyrie ones now, due to the fact that there's a second year with the shoe. All in all, I think it's a good shoe. It's a good performer. Not great. I use the word good. Good performer. You can wear it casually. You just got to have the right colorways and the right outfits to match. I'm looking forward to KD8s. I'm looking forward to KD8s. The KD line is very nice. KD.
Everybody say trash. Here you go. KD is really trash.
Shut up.
Treasure, you know.
Alright. What's your overall opinion on this shoe?
I already told you. Well, okay. Not yet. Alright. Overall opinion. I have to give these 8.5 out of 10. Actually, no, since it's the KD 7s, I'll give him an 8 out of 10. I'm out.
Alright, so I guess I'm going to do the end of the video myself. So this is LJ Ruffin with Freaks with Sneaks.
We out.
Yeah, nigga, it's me again. I'm still around. I guess I win. You hear me in your sister's room like all the time. Can't be no girl forever on that bracelet that she bought online to do too. Couldn't take it. Might I say hasta luego, cause I'm taking all your city like I'm Carmen Sandiego. I am smoking, I'm on fire, I am blazing, don't get hurt. To my wife, this is a concert. To my black nurse, this is church. From that NYU dorm to the Emory, everyone hated me. I'm more hip-hop than you'll ever be. I'm bussin', I'm bussin' on these niggas, man. And nothing is the same again. You looking dumb as hell, man, forever sleeping on them. Your girl is not around, she busy sleeping on them. Will he fail? Now that's the wrong conversation. Terry Gross on the mic, I'm the talk of the...
Yo, what's good? It's LJ Ruffin here from Freaks for Sneaks. Thank you guys for watching the video. So make sure you guys subscribe, like, and comment. In the description box, we'll keep our Instagram and our new webpage. So thank you guys for watching. We're out.
our own.